Welcome, everyone, to another meeting of the New York State Senate Standing Committee on Women's Issues. I'd like to recognize and introduce the members of the committee who are present, our ranking members, Senator Little, Senator Gorin, and Senator Metzger. Thank you for joining us. We are also joined by my legislative and committee director, Guillermo Martinez, my counsel, Mark Mishler, and our coordinator of Albany Operations, Veronica Cruz. Please proceed to the first bill.
Morning.
Morning.
How's everybody doing?
Very well.
Welcome.
I believe you have my sheet already.
Oh, excellent. Thank you. And we'll proceed to the first bill. It's Senate Bill 2264 by Senator Boylan, an act to amend the public health law in relation to requiring disclosure by crisis pregnancy centers. Requires the disclosure by crisis pregnancy centers to clients that such center will not provide abortion or birth control services or make a referral for such services, and that such center is not a licensed medical provider. Such notice shall be conducted upon first communication or first contact with the client and shall be either in a written statement or oral communication by staff assisting the client.
Yeah, I have a big concern about this bill. I actually have a open arms pregnancy center in Glens Falls. I've looked up there all over the country and around, and they're very helpful. They do not do any medical services, so I think that this idea of questioning them. What they do is they offer services to a woman who is pregnant or has had a baby already and needs assistance. They raise funds, they provide baby products, they provide all kinds of things. They have a fundraiser, a baby bottle, and people fill it with change and contribute to them. They are volunteers. They are available to listen to a person's concerns, to answer their questions. All services are confidential and free. And it's a walk-in service, and to put this kind of information requirement would act, and to say that they can't even talk to anyone about the services. You know, we hear down here, we hear a lot, you know, women approach choice, that everything's a choice. Well, there are choices. I have to be pro-life, and that is a choice. And there are many women who choose to have their baby, and they need help. And this pregnancy centers, that's what they're about. They refer them to social services. They refer them to any place where they can get help. They offer baby furniture is donated to them, and they give it out to people. But they make it possible for a woman to choose to have their baby. And I think this is just totally unnecessary. This bill's been around. It has never passed the assembly. It never even got to committee last year. And I am an adamant no vote. And I think that anyone who really believes in a woman's choice, a right to choose, would support this legislation, would not support this legislation, would support these pregnancy centers.
So my concern is, have you had a conversation with Senator Hoylman about this?
No, I only had the bill Friday. I'd never seen the bill, to tell you the truth. It had never gotten to the Health Committee last year. Mm-hmm. And when it came out on Thursday's calendar, I got the bills at home and did the research on it. So I really, you know, I would love to see you hold the bill.
Do you have anything from Senator Hoylman with regard to this?
Such as a memo.
Because my understanding was just that they're giving the information.
Mm-hmm. But they get fined. There is a fine in here.
But that they need to, I think, just make it perfectly clear what they are. It's not that anybody's stopping them from providing any of these services.
They are not going to provide, they do not provide medical services, abortion or birth control services. And it also says they should not make a referral for such services.
Right. I think that the intent of the bill is consistent with that, but the intent is also to make sure that if if a pregnant person is seeking, whether abortion services or contraceptive services or some medical services that an organization like Open Arms does not provide, that they don't mistakenly make an appointment, for example, and then further delay possibly even necessary medical treatment.
Well, there's no appointment necessary. They can walk in when they're ready. And it's all volunteer. They're peer counseling. I have a lot of information on it. They do not, you know, intimidate anyone. They really help a person who wants to choose to have the baby.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I
just wanted to have something there.
I'm sorry.
I'm just, the situation that Senator Little described and some of the activities, I'm having read the bill, I'm not sure that there's anything that would prohibit.
Yeah, I don't think it does.
It makes it a little more difficult. They don't receive state money that they should have to report to the Department of Health.
And
verify, they have to disclose and make this big statement to anyone that they're not a licensed medical provider, which I'm sure they do. But
at any rate, that's the case. Why not have that?
It seems to me that they could just have a written statement, something that could be given out. Mm-hmm. In terms of the disclosure, but I don't see how it in any way inhibits or prohibits some of the activities that you were describing, which are all, you know, wonderful things that volunteers are doing.
If such notification is not provided, a complaint can be filed by the Department of Health, investigated within 30 days, a civil fine of not more than $100 on the first violation, not more than $250.
But Senator, based on it, I understand, really trying to help. So they're not really putting any misinformation out there. It's not that they're doing something that they would be held accountable for not doing.
Well, I just think it puts the onus on them of all this kind of disclosure, and I just think it's totally wrong type of bill, and I'm a no vote on this.
Okay.
I think it's to people who are trying to help people who do want to have a baby.
Motion is to move the bill. Senator Metzger? Second. Mm-hmm.
Second.
In favor. And yes?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Mm-hmm.
No.
And the bill has been reported. Next is a Senate Bill 2387 by Senator Persaud, an act to amend the general business law in relation to menstrual product labeling. Relates to menstrual product labeling, requires the label affixed thereto or package inserted upon which there shall be plainly and conspicuously printed a list of all ingredients with percentages of the components, requires labels for single-use dispensers. Any questions?
I have a long history of this. When we try to put a special label and a special thing for New York State on a product that is sold nationally, it makes it more difficult to get that product in New York State and more expensive. And so, you know, I think that there may be some toxic things, but you know, there aren't a lot of choices in these actual hygiene product, so I'm a no vote. It should be something that we do nationally if it's that big of a concern.
I'm happy to move the bill.
Motion to move the bill. Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. The bill is reported to first reading. Next is Senate Bill 4947 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the public health law in relation to healthcare and wellness education and outreach programs on the donation of postnatal tissue and fluids. This legislation encourages and establishes awareness for the options of donation of postnatal tissue and fluids that includes placenta, umbilical cord, and amniotic fluid. These tissue and fluids can be used to benefit and heal patients with a variety of medical needs. Any questions, comments?
I will actually move the bill just to show that I'm not totally house.
I would like to second it because I actually did attend while we were away. One of the hospitals was talking about tissue and organ donation and how we are such, New York really failing miserably.
Yeah.
And that what we could do to bring more awareness and put the word out for people to know, and people were interested to sign up and to be organ and tissue donors.
All right, so we have a motion to move the bill from Senator Little and a second from Senator Kaplan. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Bill is reported, referred to finance.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for the business of this committee. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.